we are discussing the clinical types of multiple sclerosis. Types of multiple sclerosis. The number first type is relapsing multiple sclerosis. Relapsing multiple sclerosis. That is RMS. Relapsing multiple sclerosis. The relapsing multiple sclerosis accounts for 90% of multiple sclerosis causes. This is the 90% multiple sclerosis cases. The relapsing multiple sclerosis, that is RMS, accounts for 90% of multiple sclerosis cases. And this RMS is characterized by discrete attack of neurological dysfunction. They generally evolve over days to weeks. There is discrete attack of neurological dysfunction. Discrete attacks of neurological dysfunction. This dysfunction lasts from days to weeks. This is the short duration, from days to weeks. With the initial attack of the RMS, there is often substantial or complete recovery over the ensuing weeks to months. At initial stages of the RMS, there is complete recovery. The complete recovery occurs at the initial stages. However, as attacks continue, recovery may be less evident. If attacks continue, recovery is less. Now we discuss the second type of multiple sclerosis. The second type of multiple sclerosis, that is secondary progressive multiple sclerosis. Second type is secondary progressive multiple sclerosis. Secondary progressive multiple sclerosis. The secondary progressive multiple sclerosis always begin as relapsing multiple sclerosis. They always begin as a relapsing multiple sclerosis. This relapsing multiple sclerosis that lasts from weeks to days and sometimes complete recovery occurs. This may change into secondary progressive multiple sclerosis. The secondary progressive multiple sclerosis, the patient experience the dysfunction with acute attack. The secondary progressive multiple sclerosis produces a greater amount of fixed neurological disability. They produce fixed neurological disability. Fixed neurological disability produced by the secondary progressive multiple sclerosis. So the secondary progressive multiple sclerosis produces a greater amount of fixed neurological disability than the relapsing multiple sclerosis. For a patient with relapsing multiple sclerosis, the risk of developing the secondary progressive multiple sclerosis chances 2% each year, means that the majority of relapsing multiple sclerosis ultimately evolve into secondary progressive multiple sclerosis. This, the relapsing multiple sclerosis convert into progressive multiple sclerosis 2% each year, secondary progressive multiple sclerosis is a result of the relapsing multiple sclerosis. The secondary progressive multiple sclerosis appears to represent a late stage of the same underlying illness. So there is the same underlying illness in the relapsing multiple sclerosis. Now we'll discuss the third type of multiple sclerosis. The third type is primary progressive multiple sclerosis. What is the primary progressive multiple sclerosis? In the primary progressive multiple sclerosis, it accounts for 10% of the cases. So this accounts for 10% of cases of multiple sclerosis. These patients do not experience attacks, but rather they decline in the function from disease onset. Compared to the relapsing multiple sclerosis, the sixth distribution is more even. The disease begins later in the life. Mean age is 40 years. The mean age for the primary progressive multiple sclerosis is 40 years later in life. And disability develops faster relative to the onset of the first clinical symptoms. The disability in the primary progressive multiple sclerosis, the disability develop earlier than other types of multiple sclerosis. Disability develop earlier. So this is the primary progressive multiple sclerosis. Now we will discuss the epidemiology of multiple sclerosis. So what is the epidemiology for multiple sclerosis? Multiple sclerosis is approximately threefold more common in women than men. This is threefold more common in women than men. So the chances of multiple sclerosis in women is threefold greater than in men. The age of the onset is typically between 20 and 40 years. The mean age is range from 20 to 40 years of life. Slightly later in the men than women. So this disease occurs earlier in women. Earlier life in women, this disease occurs in women. But the disease can present across the lifespan. Approximately 10% of cases begin before the age of 18 years. 10% of cases of multiple sclerosis begins before 18 years of life. Before 18 years of life. That is adulthood. And a small percentage of cases begins before the age of 10 years. At small percent, even multiple sclerosis can occur before the age of 10. Before age 10 year of life. So this is a disease that may occur in small percentage before the 10 year of age. 10% cases occur before the 18 year of life. And greater the symptoms occur in the earlier in the women, and threefold that is more common in the women than men. This is the epidemiology of multiple sclerosis. Now we will discuss the other epidemiological factor of multiple sclerosis. The geographical gradients are observed in multiple sclerosis, with the highest known prevalence for multiple sclerosis. There is 250 cases per 1 lakh in the islands located in the Scotland, near the Scotland, North Scotland. So there is 250 cases per 1 lakh. 250 cases per 1 lakh in the Scotland. In Scotland, 250 cases are reported. In other temperate zone areas, for example, Northern America or Northern Europe or South Australia and Southern New Zealand, the prevalence of multiple sclerosis is 0.1 to 0.2%. Temperate countries, for example, North America or other areas, like Australia, the multiple sclerosis is 0.1 to 0.2% of cases are reported of the multiple sclerosis in these areas. It is North America, Australia. In the tropics area, example Asia and Africa, in the Middle East, the prevalence is often 10-fold to 20-fold less. In Asia and other tropical countries, the cases of multiple sclerosis is 20 to 30 fold less compared to the temperate countries. In the tropical areas, there is less. The prevalence of multiple sclerosis is associated steadily and dramatically in several regions around the world. Over the past half century, the impact of some environmental shift also indicates the disease. Moreover, the fact that the increase has occurred primarily for women. The cases are more in the women. That indicate that the women are more responsible for the disease. That is multiple sclerosis. Women are more affected than men. Threefold more than men. Now we will discuss the risk factors. A well-established risk factor for multiple sclerosis include a genetic predisposition, vitamin D deficiency, Epstein-Barr virus exposures after early childhood, and cigarette smoking. Risk factor for multiple sclerosis include vitamin D deficiency, Epstein-Barr virus exposures at early childhood, and cigarette smoking, especially in the women. Cigarette smoking. Now we discuss how vitamin D deficiency, its bar virus exposure, and cigarette smoking in the women is a higher risk factor for developing the multiple sclerosis. Vitamin D deficiency is associated with increased risk in multiple sclerosis, and data suggest that iron deficiency also increases the disease activity after multiple sclerosis begins. The immunoregulatory effects of vitamin D could explain the apparent relationship. So there is the immunoregulatory effect, multiple sclerosis. Immunoregulatory effects in multiple sclerosis. Exposure of the skin to ultraviolet B radiation from the sun is essential for the biosynthesis of vitamin D. So the sun exposure for the biosynthesis of vitamin D is important. Sun exposure. So we say that the multiple sclerosis more developed in the temperate area, so there is low sun exposure and there is less vitamin D in the body, so there is less sun exposure. Vitamin D synthesis sufficiently not occurred. There is development of multiple sclerosis. Risk factors include a highest altitude. The amount of ultraviolet B radiation reaching the earth's surface is often insufficient, particularly during the winter months, and consequently low serum levels of vitamin D are common in temperate zone. So this is due to temperate zone, the deficiency of vitamin D, the risk factor of multiple sclerosis increases. What is the Epstein-Barr virus anomaly causes the multiple sclerosis? The higher risk of infection of mononucleosis associated relatively by Epstein-Barr virus infection in higher antibody titer to latency associated with Epstein-Barr virus nuclear antigen have been repeated associated multiple sclerosis risk. Although the causal agent role of multiple sclerosis is not established. But there is some cases that the Epstein-Barr virus anomaly can cause the multiple sclerosis risk factors. Now we discuss the genetic consideration in the multiple sclerosis. Genetic consideration in the case of multiple sclerosis. Whites are inherently at higher risk of multiple sclerosis than African or Asians. Whites have higher risk of developing the multiple sclerosis than Asian or African. Multiple sclerosis also aggregates within some families and have sibling twins. There is also the familial multiple sclerosis. Susceptibility to multiple sclerosis is polygenic, with each gene contributing a relatively small amount to overall risk. So the genetic is polygenic. There is polygenic type of inheritance for multiple sclerosis. The strongest susceptibility signal genome-wide MAP to the HLA-DRG1 gene in the class 2 region in the major histocompatibility complex and associated for 10% of cases of the risk. HLA-DRB1 is 10% of the risk in the multiple sclerosis. 10% of risk. Mutation in the HLA-DRB1 gene occurs, there is 10% of risk in the multiple sclerosis. They represent to the major histocompatibility type 2. So the risk developing in the multiple sclerosis due to the genetic causes. Now we discuss the ratio of the genetic consideration in which the multiple sclerosis occur. The multiple sclerosis occur 1 in 3 if the identical twins has multiple sclerosis. So the multiple sclerosis occur 1 in 3 people if the twin has multiple sclerosis. The multiple sclerosis occur 1 in 15 if a fraternal twin has multiple sclerosis. 1 in 15 if a fraternal twin has multiple sclerosis. So out of 15, one may affect it. The multiple sclerosis occur 1 in 25 if a sibling has multiple sclerosis. Out of 25 people, one patient may affect it if the sibling has multiple sclerosis. The multiple sclerosis may occur 1 in 50 if a parent or half sibling has multiple sclerosis. If a parent or half sibling has multiple sclerosis. Multiple sclerosis occur 1 in 100 patient, 1 out of 100 patient, if the first cousin has multiple sclerosis. Multiple sclerosis occur 1 out of 100, 1 out of 100, 1 out of 100, if the first cousin has multiple sclerosis. If the first cousin has multiple sclerosis, out of 100, 1 may be affected. The multiple sclerosis occur 1 in out of 1,000 if a spouse has multiple sclerosis. 1 out of 1,000 if spouse has multiple sclerosis. The multiple sclerosis occur in 1 out of 1,000 if one in the family has multiple sclerosis. Occur 1 out of 1,000 if out of 1,000 if one member of the family has, if one member in family, close family history, that is close family, has multiple sclerosis. So this was the genetical consideration about multiple sclerosis. Now we discuss the pathogenesis of multiple sclerosis. The pathogenesis of multiple sclerosis. Pathogenesis of multiple sclerosis. What is the pathogenesis of multiple sclerosis? That, what is the pathology? That how multiple sclerosis occur? The new multiple sclerosis lesions begins with perivenular coupling. That is inflammation in the mononuclear cells, predominantly in the T cells in macrophages, and also infiltrate the surrounding white matter. So there is the